Hi, my name is Nick Bronn. I'm a researcher at IBM Quantum. I use Qiskit for quantum computing education and research. Today, we're going to talk about getting started with Qiskit, either locally on your computer or over the cloud. We'll also talk about how we get access to IBM Quantum backends that are open and freely available, also over the cloud. In a separate video, we'll talk about installing and contributing to the development branch of Qiskit. This is useful for researchers and developers in the field who need access to the latest and greatest versions. Maybe not the stable ones that we're going to talk about today. Let's start by navigating to Qiskit.org, everyone's favorite open source quantum development toolkit. You can scroll down to the Get Started button, click on it. And then the quickest way to get started with Qiskit is over the cloud. So let's navigate to the Start on the Cloud tab, and then click on the IBM Quantum Lab button. If you haven't already, you'll need to create an IBM ID account. Once you're done with that, click on the IBM ID button to sign in. Two-factor authentication. Two-factor authentication, kids. Always a good idea. After logging in, you'll be taken to the IBM Quantum dashboard. Since this is an important page we'll be coming back to, we'll launch the lab in a new tab. On the left, you'll see your lab files, which includes the Qiskit textbook and tutorials for learning features of Qiskit. In particular, we'll get started with this Getting Started notebook that you can download and then upload to the Quantum dashboard. Once you've downloaded the Getting Started notebook, click on the Upload button and upload it from there. Once you've done that, the notebook will appear here. Double-click to open it. This will open up the Jupyter notebook, and we can see we're starting with loading libraries from Qiskit that we need. In particular, we need to load the IBM Q provider. A provider is a host that provides access to different kinds of quantum backends. In order to see what kinds of backends we have access to, we need to navigate back to the dashboard and click on View Account Details. Scrolling to the bottom, you can see your providers. I have a lot of them because I've been around for a while, but everyone has access to the IBM Q Open Main provider. Clicking on the three dots next to it, you can copy the Qiskit provider code, which we'll need for our notebook, and we'll navigate back there now. Now I'll paste that provider information into this first cell and execute it by pressing Shift Enter. This will take a few seconds to load. Here we've output a list of backends provided by the IBM Q provider. This includes simulators, as well as access to actual quantum processors. For this example, any of these backends will do the trick, but RMoC only operates on one qubit, so we're not going to use that. In fact, I'll choose IBM Q Santiago. So we'll just copy that and paste it into the get backend method given by the provider. Then we can execute that cell and take a look at the backend itself. We can see the connectivity of Santiago, but we'll talk about that another time. Let's move on to building our first quantum circuit. This code will generate a Bell state. Pressing Shift Enter will show what the circuit diagram of that state looks like. I like the Bell state because it shows both the quantum effects of superposition and entanglement. Next, we'll take a job that creates a Bell state and performs a measurement and send it to the actual quantum hardware. Each job has a unique ID that we can print out to get the results later if we desire. Now the job is queued and we're waiting to run it on the actual hardware. And after a short wait, our job has successfully run. So let's plot the results. Here we see likely probabilities for measuring either the 0-0 or 1-1 state, which is a good indicator we prepared a Bell state. And that's how you get started with Qiskit on the cloud. And that's how you get started with Qiskit on the cloud. Now I'll show you how to get started locally with Qiskit. We're going to use the Anaconda distribution of Python. So navigate to anaconda.com, select products, individual edition, and download the open source free distribution for your particular operating system. Once you follow the install instructions, open up a terminal or an Anaconda prompt depending on your operating system. Here's mine right here, and we can see that I'm in the base Conda environment. In order to keep things clean, we're going to manage our Conda environments, and we can look at what we have by doing Conda env list. Today, we're going to create a stable Conda environment that we can use for our stable install of Qiskit. So I'll do Conda create dash env for name, Qiskit dash stable, and then I like to use the latest version of Python myself. proceed, hit Y at the prompt, and we're going to be installing things for a little while. Now that that's done, let's activate our new environment. Conda activate Qiskit stable. Okay, now it's very easy to install Qiskit. We just type in pip install Qiskit. And because I like all the visualization tools that come with using Jupyter Notebooks, I'm going to add those libraries in here as well by typing visualization in brackets. And if you're on a recent macOS version like me, you need to put those in quotation marks. This will take a few minutes to run. It's a great time to grab a cup of coffee. I think I'm gonna grab a cup of coffee. So now that that's finished, let's install a separate IPython kernel so we can keep track of which version of Qiskit we're running inside of our Jupyter Notebooks. We can do that by typing in python-m ipykernel install --user for everyone --name. We'll call it the same thing, Qiskit stable, and then give it the display name, Qiskit stable as well. Okay, that was quick. And one more thing we're gonna do is install Rise so that we can view Jupyter Notebooks in presentation mode. And we can do that easily by typing in pip install Rise. All right, now that we're done installing packages, let's launch our Getting Started Notebook. We can do that with Jupyter Notebook Getting Started. Note that Jupyter is spelled with a Y because it's Python. This will open the notebook in a new tab in your default browser. Once we open the notebook, we can check our kernel is correct by seeing the Qiskit stable here in the upper right. That's the one we just installed. That's got the Qiskit stable version in it. Then we can go into presentation mode by clicking this graph right here. The first thing we can do is make sure we installed the latest stable version of Qiskit. Again, this might take a moment to load the libraries. Checking the version table, we can confirm that we are indeed running the latest stable version of Qiskit. Pressing space to move on, I can then go and import the libraries that I need, very similar to what we did on the cloud. One thing that's different from the IBM Quantum Lab is that we need to store our account information locally. In order to do this, navigate back to the IBM Quantum dashboard and copy your API token. Now, navigating back to the notebook, we need to put that account number in quotes. As you can see, my credentials are already present. This is something you only need to do your first time, and it's best not to keep your account number around. So we'll delete that. Since the API token is saved locally, we don't need it anymore and we can just load our account. We'll use the same provider and same backend that we did on the cloud. Now let's create the same bell state that we did in the cloud example. We can see the circuit here, Hadamard followed by a CNOT. Since we're running locally, we might want to install a widget such as the job watcher so we can see how the jobs are going. Taking the same job that consists of creating a bell state followed by a measurement, we'll send it to the same actual quantum hardware. Looking up at the widget, we can see our job ID, the backend we submitted it to, and where we are in the queue. In the meantime, we can use the job ID to pull the results from a previously run job. We can get the results from the same job and plot the histogram and see we get the same telltale sign of entanglement. So that's how you get started locally, and this time we showed you how to plot the results of a previously run job. So that's how you get started with Qiskit, either locally or on the cloud. In a future video, we'll cover installing the development branch of Qiskit. Do you have an idea of something we should cover? Let us know in the comments below. I've been your host, Nick Bronn. Thanks a lot for watching.